Saudi Crown Prince and de facto ruler Mohammed bin Salman and U.S. Secretary of State Antony Blinken discussed bilateral relations in Riyadh. Saudi state media reported the two also discussed cooperation on various fields, including clean energy and technology. Blinken is on a mission to study Washington's relationship with Riyadh after years of deepening disagreements on issues ranging from regional security to oil prices. His visit also comes after Saudi, the world's oil exporter, decided to further cut oil production. A graduation ceremony turns tragic in the U.S. A man armed with four handguns killed two people and wounded five others when he fired into a crowd outside a high school in Richmond, Virginia. Police have arrested a 19-year-old suspect who knew one of the victims. The Richmond police chief said the shooter appeared to have a dispute with that victim. This is the 279th mass shooting in the U.S. this year. It's the widow of murdered Korean businessman Ji Ik-joo and the Korean community in the Philippines up in arms over the acquittal of the crime's alleged mastermind. A Pampanga court found police officer Ricky Santa Isabel and former NBI aide Jerry Omlang guilty in the kidnapping and killing of G right inside the National Police Headquarters in 2016. The court, however, acquitted the alleged mastermind, Superintendent Rafael Dumlao, due to the prosecution's failure to prove his guilt beyond reasonable doubt. The Korean community expressed disappointment over that ruling.
He was the one who just, we believe that he was the one who just organized and committed of the, all this happened. But now, several years later, things has been changed. So that he is not guilty. We don't believe that. Mr. Dumlao, we won't forget it. Really disappointed of the Philippine government.
The world economy is in a precarious position. That statement from the World Bank after its latest global economic prospects report showed global growth will slow down sharply in the second half of 2023 as interest rate increases and high inflation hit activity, making lower-income countries even more vulnerable. The multilateral lender added the aggressive monetary tightening is boosting the likelihood emerging market and developing economies could face a financial crisis. The World Bank had actually raised its 2023 global growth forecast to 2.1% from 1.7% predicted in January, but this is still slower than last year's actual growth of 3.1%. As for the Philippines, economic growth is seen slowing to 6% this year from last year's 7.6%. NBA Phil-American star Jordan Clarkson and naturalized player Justin Brownlee are both included in Gilas Pilipinas' 21-man pool for the upcoming FIBA World Cup here in Manila. The Samahang Basketball ng Pilipinas is hopeful FIBA will allow the national team to field both Clarkson and Brownlee, who recently led Gilas to the gold medal in the Southeast Asian Games. Also included in that pool are PBA veteran Scotty Thompson, Junimar Fajardo, and CJ Perez, as well as young overseas stars Dwight Ramos, Renz Abando, and Carl Tamayo. The Philippines will play Italy, Angola, and the Dominican Republic in the group stage of the World Cup. And Miami will be hosting its first NBA Finals game in 9 years when the Heat and the Denver Nuggets collide in Game 3. Our North America Bureau correspondent Steve Angeles tells us how both teams are preparing for tomorrow's big game.
After splitting the first two games of the NBA Finals in Denver, Colorado, the Miami Heat are back home. Both the Heat and the Denver Nuggets opened up their practice to the media on Tuesday afternoon, with the Heat's most recent finals appearance taking place in the 2020 pandemic bubble. Wednesday night will be the first time Miami has hosted an NBA Finals game in 9 years.
I think being at home in general, sleeping in your bed, you know, being able to do the things at home that you're comfortable with, you know, getting home-cooked meals, all that, that benefits it. But the benefit of the crowd is no matter what, they're going to be behind you. They're going to give you energy. They're, you know, if you the other team's on a run, they're going to give you a little boost, right? You know, the other team, if you're on a run, it's going to be a crazy boost. And I think just the overall, you know, energy for your team and your group. It will give you a little bit of a lift, but it won't win you the game since you still got to go out there and hoop. So, but it will give you some type of, you know, good feeling.
The 8th seed Heat got major contributions from its bench in the first two finals games, especially with Kyle Lowry, who won an NBA championship with the Toronto Raptors in 2019.
Our second unit now is one of our biggest strengths as a team, and we were struggling with our second unit, you know, for various reasons for most of the season, and he kind of just fixed all that on his own.
Spoelstra, now in his 15th season, explained to the media that the days off in between games are just as important for relaxing as game planning.
We know our group. They live on the razor's edge. You know, there's an edginess to this group. The on button is usually on, and I think we've found, you know, better ways, more productive ways in the moments in between, just to not exhale, not to relax, but just to recharge, get our minds off of that, you know, so that you can gear up the next day emotionally, physically, spiritually, all of those things. It's tough to always be like on that on button. And this group, you know, has shown a maturity level to be able to handle both. And we'll see, you know, tomorrow night. But in a moment like this, yeah, I want our guys relaxing. And when they get out of here, I'd love for them to get their minds off of it. I know how they all are. They want to, you know, be like that all the time.
Players like Bam Adebayo believe Spoelstra's lengthy experience has been a key to the Heat's success.
He's been to how many finals at this point? So he's seen everything but the win. So, you know, him being in those moments, him cherishing those moments, I feel like he's comfortable here. You know, he isn't making anything up. He isn't trying to figure it out with this, that, and third. Like, he's been through so much with so many other great players that, you know, I feel like he settles in these moments. This is when he really gets comfortable. It's when he doesn't get really rattled. And this is when he comes up with the game plan for us to be successful.
Over in the Nuggets locker room, Coach Michael Malone said his team has been studying the film, and it will take a full 48 minutes of discipline to overcome Miami, who has been proven to finish strong, especially in the fourth quarter.
It's not just one player right now, whether it's Michael, Jamal, Aaron, Pope, Nicole, whoever. We have to be a lot more disciplined, a lot more urgent. And if you really want to simplify the first two games, in the first three quarters, we have dominated both games. The Miami Heat are dominating in the fourth quarter. They're averaging 33 points a game in the fourth quarter, shooting over 60% from the field in the fourth quarter, and over 50% from three.
Game three of the best of seven series tips off on Wednesday night at the Kessia Center. Steve Angeles, ABS-CBN News.
Now, a stunning development in golf. Rivals, the PGA Tour and Saudi-backed LIV Circuit have announced a merger. More in this report.
In a landmark agreement on Tuesday, the PGA Tour, DP World Tour, and Saudi-backed LIV Golf announced they will merge into one commercial entity to unify golf, bringing an end to what had been a bitter split in the sport. It comes after the PGA Tour had sought to fend off competition from LIV by barring PGA Tour players from participating in LIV tournaments. In a joint statement, PGA Tour Commissioner Jay Monahan said, quote, "After 2 years of disruption and distraction, this is a historic day for the game we all know and love." Additionally, the three organizations vowed to work cooperatively to allow a process for any LIV golf players to reapply for PGA Tour and DP World Tour memberships following the 2023 season. The announcement of the merger includes an agreement to end all pending litigation between the participating parties. The LIV Golf Series, which launched last year, is bankrolled by the Saudi Arabia Public Investment Fund, and critics have accused it of being a vehicle for the country to attempt to improve its reputation in the face of criticism over its human rights record. LIV Golf had lured big-name players away from the rival circuits with staggering sums of prize money for every golfer. Among the more popular players who made the move to LIV Golf were Hall of Fame golfer Phil Mickelson, former world number one Dustin Johnson, reigning PGA Championship winner Brooks Koepka, and 2022 British Open winner Cameron Smith. Mickelson hailed the news in a tweet saying, quote, "Awesome day today." No details were given as to how the agreement will impact the current competitive golf landscape, including eligibility for this year's Ryder Cup, though the parties did say they will work in the coming months to finalize terms of the merger.
Filipino fans were ecstatic as they got the chance to meet Hollywood star Chris Hemsworth, who visited Manila to promote his new film, Extraction 2. Gretchen Folido has that story.
Fans filled the Mall of Asia in Pasay City, excited to see their idols Chris Hemsworth and director Sam Hargrave at the red carpet event of their new Netflix film, Extraction 2. The red carpet event was star-studded with local celebrities and international personalities from the Asia-Pacific region.
Lucky Pinoy fans got up close and personal with their idol Chris Hemsworth and director Sam Hargrave here at the red carpet premiere of Extraction 2 in the Philippines.
But there was one lucky fan that got to go on stage, got a big hug from Hemsworth, and had a photo with Chris and Sam. During the fan meet, Hemsworth and Hargrave shared that the fight scene in Extraction 2 was the hardest action scene that they've done in their careers.
The experience is as if it was one shot, but because we have so many different elements, so many different moving parts, sometimes literally like moving trains.
It was exhausting. As Sam said, it was twice as long as the original one. And we were shooting in the Czech Republic, freezing, snowing. We're on a train going about 40 miles, 50 miles an hour. I was on top of the train. There's a helicopter in front of me flying backwards, and all sorts of action sequences and car chases and so on. It was the most elaborate stunt sequence and fight choreography that I'd ever been handed and asked to learn. And when we got onto set, we just hit the ground running and beat the hell out of each other. It was fun.
Chris also has this message to his Filipino fans.
Mahal kita.
You can watch Extraction 2 on Netflix starting June 16. Gretchen Folido, ABS-CBN News.